Hello everyone, Trix here, and welcome back to Minigame Land. We have fully covered Minigame Stadium in the last couple of times. A couple of weekends it took. And there's one thing we still need to do. Before we head into Minigame Coaster. We have one minigame left to buy. It's the item minigame that shows up in Bowser Land, even though we have not played Bowser Land yet. But I'm still buying the minigame. Thank you. This is the last minigame. Well, that means... Congratulations! You now have purchased every minigame. Let me give you this rare minigame in honor of your feat. Wanna test your skills in Driver's Ed? No? Of course we do. Driver's Ed is the minigame you unlock if you buy every single minigame in the game. It's a special minigame. You can only play it here. It's no minigame that shows up on boards or anything. It's just a little... one-off you can have fun with. Driver's Ed consists out of 5 courses which you can drive around on. As you can see, of course we're going to start with the first one, and we're also going to get an explanation screen. Drive through the cones in order written on the balloons. Try to finish in the fastest time possible. If you don't pass through the cones in the direction of the arrow, or if you pass through in the wrong order, you miss. Controls. This should look familiar because this minigame is based on the driving mechanics of Magnet Carta and Bumper Balloon Cars. So, yeah, you know how I'm not a fan of the mechanics of that kart mechanics, you might say. Not really a kart, but... Anyway, they have made some... driving courses with those mechanics where you can only ride around on the way you're supposed to do it. In this case, go through the balloons in order. The first one is very easy, as you can see. Right, course number one cleared. That's just to test out how it works. Trust me, they get pretty annoying with arrows going in opposite directions and everything. You can already see it here. This looks annoying already, and there's only the second one. See it here. Balloon number two is in the opposite direction as the first one is, so you actually need to make a 180 degrees through all these cones. Pretty annoying. No, ah, dang it! This is what I mean. And yeah, if you make a mistake, you're out. And you have to go in all over again. I'm not too accustomed to this minigame, in all honesty. I have to admit that the controls are a lot better than they are in Bumper Balloon Cars or Magnet Carta. This does seem to be a little bit more forgiving. At least you can turn normally here if you are at full speed. That's where the biggest trip rope is in this minigame. The arrows going in opposite directions. You have a tendency to go look at the balloons. Oh, there's the next one. Concentrating is hard. Yeah, if you see... Oh, there's the next one. You also need to take into account that you actually need to take it in the right direction. And that's where the trouble comes in here. Yeah, I'm not gonna go for super good times or anything. I'm just going to clear and I'm going to say that is enough. As long as you are under a minute, you get a new record, and that's, in my book, enough to clear. That's all I'm going to do. That's all you have to do, in all honesty. Going for as low time as possible, that's just testing out yourself. I'm just here to show them off. So mean. They go in the same direction, 1 and 2. This one goes like this. Turn around for this one. 7, 2. It goes like this. Oh, 9 is the other way. Where's 10? Ah, oh, there it is. I It can also be annoying that sometimes the next balloon is not on screen, so you have actually have to start looking or just remember from dang it, from previous attempts where they are. Learn the course in order to make your time faster and faster. There's more as you learn what turns to take. Not going to apply for me, of course. I'm just going to do this once every single time. I'm only going to try again if I fail. As long as I reach the finish line, it's going to be my only attempt. Right, how does this one look? Oh, I see a lot of arrows going in opposite directions, so there's a lot of turning around here. Nothing we aren't used to yet. We can do this. Or I can. You're not the ones playing. Well, you might be. Who doesn't play Mario Party 2? Shame on you! 7... Oh, come on! Stupid cone. Took that turn a little too early. I'm getting the hang of this. Eventually. Once I get the hang of this, I'm already done with this. Oh, need to go around. Should have gone the other way. But hey, it's still under a minute. That's all what counts. Right, and with that, we have one more. Course number 5. As long as people stop screaming outside. Yeah, my static filter should filter that out. Because it's always so noisy outside, it's a busy street, and also in the house it can be quite noisy. I always use a static filter to filter out those background noises. It works pretty well, because you rarely hear anything when I say, oh, there's a lot of noise outside now, outside my door, or just outside in general, outside my window. And you rarely hear it on the video, so it works pretty well. It also distorts my voice a lot, but still, you can still hear what I'm saying, even though my voice, in all honesty, doesn't really sound the way it in real life sounds like. But still, it keeps me a mystery. My voice a mystery, my face a mystery. It's what I like to be a mystery. But anyway, I've almost got my driver's license now, because driver's ed is going to be a piece of cake for me. Once I've cleared all 5 of them, I have my Mario Party 2 driver's license. I can officially play bumper balloon cars and magnet karts without failure. Trust me, it doesn't work like that. Yeah, this is the longest one, but in all honesty, not the hardest one. Here we go. And that is Driver's Ed. That is what you unlock if every single minigame has been bought. Play around with it. I usually don't, because I'm not the biggest fan of this one. Right. Is that all we're going to do for today? No, of course not. We still have some other minigames to show off, but we also got some records to show off. If you have played Driver's Ed, there's now a second page in your records showing off the records for Driver's Ed. That also gets added. You can also find them in the Option Laboratory. Right, let's get in Minigame Park. We've been here briefly before Spaceland, to receive some new minigames from Piranha Plant, but that's all we did here. Let's officially go in here now and actually do some playing here this time around. Let's randomly put in some guys, I don't care who. Let's super hard these guys, because this is in all honesty going to be the final chance for me to do so. So, say goodbye to super hard after today. Minigame Coaster doesn't have a super hard. And the board playthroughs also don't. What have we missed? Let's get my list ready. Why is that not ready? We've seen all of these. We have not seen one of the roll calls. We still have the toad roll calls to do, so let's do them now. Type 1 of roll calls counting toads. We've only been counting Bob-ombs and Boos. In fact, the minigame only came by twice. Seven, 16, 20, 22. Yeah, I think it is 23. Yeah, when counting toads, not so much of an issue. You only have to make sure you don't count the mushrooms. But they're clearly visible, so why would you count them? Yeah, it's 23. I knew it. I haven't lost this minigame a single time. I've been correct every single time. It's not so hard to count. The boos are definitely the hardest one, in all honesty. But even those are not undoable. Right, we've seen all the roll calls now. Right, we have... seen all of these. Slot Car Derby. Yeah. Slot Car Derby has one track we have not seen yet. The second one. The first one showed up twice. The third one showed up once. But this one didn't show up at all. So let's show it off here. Even though a minigame coaster, we're also going to see it. But I assumed we've already seen it then. Even though it was before Spaceland even. Man, that's going to be weird. But I am weird, so... Right, let's see if we can beat this minigame on Super Hard. I have not played this one on Super Hard, of course. What a time to slip out. Yeah, I'm not winning this one. Super Hard, no way you're going to get away with slipping out. I'm still ahead, though. Yeah, this track is not that hard. It's a little bit more cornery than the first one, but not as much as the first one. How did I win that? Probably the same reason I won Bumps Away on Super Hard. Because Super Hard computers fail to be super hard sometimes. Alright, that scratches off the four players entirely. Once versus three, we have one ball over we still need to see, the second one. You might not recognize this one, because the ball over courses tend to look like a lot. But the one banking left a little bit, we actually have not seen yet. So, just for completion's sake, just because the game calls this a different variant, I'm also going to call it a different variant. This one we have not seen, the other two we have. See if I can get them in one go again, like always. Yeah. Computers suck at this one. Mario Party 1, they're more formidable. Right, we can scratch that one. Right, what else do we have? Let me see. This one, of course, move to the music. But let's look ahead first. Lights out, we have seen. Yeah, only the move to the music. This one came by a lot of times, in all honesty, but every single time the first song, never the second one. Only Rhythm Shakers came by, but there's also Dancing Star. A little harder, because this one, on the first go, gives you 5 button inputs instead of 4. That's the only difference, and the music, of course. This one did not came by. Copy that, fools. Good job, Wario. Very first one and you fail. Super Hard computers to the rescue. Right. Well, thank God I lost. I would have doubted Super Hard even more. Even though 2 of them still failed. But yeah, that's the second song. Try to be quiet a little bit so you can hear it. But that is the move to the music we have not seen yet, the harder variant. Right, what do we have for 2 versus 2? Let me see. We have seen both of these. Toad Bandstand, this one does not have a variant. These don't have a variant. We've seen all 3 of these. Oh, we're done with 2 versus 2. Yeah, my list agrees with that. So, in that case, we only have battle minigames to cover. Most notably, Facelift. We have seen all of these. No variants. Yeah. So, facelift is the only one left. After all that hassle, we still have one minigame to show off some variants. In this case, some faces we still need to pull. Luigi's face failed to show up. I love pulling Luigi's face now, because he screwed me over on Horrorland. So let's horrify his face. Right, he's down here. His mouth, that is. His ears... Oh, not that wide. I still need to adjust my death zone in my controller. It's also tripping me up here. Even though I've been able to score perfects in this minigame earlier, so... No, the ears is a little bit more... The head is up also. This does not look too good. I'm not winning this one. Yeah, I tripped up on a couple of things, most notably the hat. But it doesn't matter. Peach we've seen. We still need some reptilian face to pull. Yoshi is the final one we have not seen yet. After that, we can officially say the only minigame we have not seen yet is Bowser Land's item minigame, but that's going to show up there, so we'll see it there. Right, Yoshi's cheeks. There's a lot of stuff that fits in there, as we know from all the games in the past. In all honesty, Yoshi's face is the least interesting one to pull, because he doesn't really have a face, because he's not a humanoid after all, so his face is a little bit different. There's only a couple of things you can do. Can't make anything better out of this, I'm afraid. Oh, pretty high, but the other guy scored higher. Right, note to self, don't play facelift on super hard. These guys know what they're doing. And the rest we've seen. Alrighty then. That means that the only minigame not accounted for is item minigame number 6. That will show up on the board when we play Bowser Slots. You can see a little glimpse of the future here. That's the only one we still have to see. Other than that, we are done. Because, in all honesty, I can sit here for another hour and think of things to do, but we have covered everything in the game, with the exception of the final board and minigame coaster, but I officially already covered that. I just still need to put the videos up. Those will be going up next weekend. Minigame coaster is what normally is used to unlock the ability to buy battle and item minigames when you clear it on normal and hard. That is the reason I already did it, because being able to buy the battle and item minigames was kind of required for me to do the rest, so I was forced to do it early. But I am not forced to show it off early. Next time, the next 2 weekends, because I already did it, I know how many videos it is going to take. It's going to take 6 videos. So, the coming 2 weekends, I could have decided to do it three weekends, 2 videos. But I'm lenient. Mario Party is an expanded weekend project in most cases anyway, so I decided to expand it with Minigame Coaster as well. 3 videos per weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Showing off the easy and normal mode first, and then the hard mode in the second weekend. And after that, I'm afraid there's nothing more to do other than close off the project. After Minigame Coaster, Bowser Land is coming up. And that'll be the finale. So, we have 3 more weekends of Mario Party. And then it is done, and it will be the wait for Mario Party 3. But for now, I thank you for watching. If you thought this was interesting enough to click on it, I can understand if you didn't think so, but still, it is part of the deal. So this also needed to be covered, and with this, I did. Thanks for watching, and see you next weekend when Past Treaks is going to take over for Minigame Coaster. Treaks out.